Shalom Aleichem and welcome to Online Smicha. We know great things that the Chazal tell us in the Gemara, and it's brought in Shulchan Aruch, of being Mesameach Chasim V'Kala. And the Sudas Chasim V'Kala, the Sudas of the Suda during the wedding, is considered a Sudas Mitzvah. And the Rambam says that even though usually Talmid HaChachamim don't hang out in restaurants, don't go out in public to eat, but specifically and only by Sudas Mitzvah, like a wedding, it is proper for a chassan and kala to be, even talmid chachamim to participate and eat, even though it's in a public place. So we see that how beautiful and how great of a mitzvah the sudas chassan v'kala, the sudas nisuyin is all about. Now there are some interesting questions about this, or discussions about the sudas chassana, originating even with the name that we call it sudas chassan. Sudas Chasim V'Kala, and today's day the minig became actually that the Kala's family, the Kala's family makes the Chasna, the actual Suda, even more than the investment that the parents of the Chasna makes. And the question is, especially according to Halacha, where the Chasna is the one that's fulfilling a mitzvah, because the mitzvah of Pru Avu is on the male, on the man, why is it that it became that the Kala or her family invests in making this wonderful Sudas Mitzvah, when really the Mitzvah is more on the Chasen? And this question is asked in many, many places. And basically the answer which is given, it's brought in Imre Emes from Ger, and there's a beautiful answer also in the Bnei Yisachar. The Imre Emes from Ger says, that's the common answer, because the Gemara says, Kol ha'nanem Sudas Chasen, that anybody who is has pleasure or benefits from a Sudas Chasen, and yet doesn't invest his time to be Mesameach Chasen V'Kala, to do something to make the Chasen or Kala happy, Rachmana Latlan, there's a punishment for that. And that, since the Gemara says that applies specifically for a Sudas Chasen, so therefore we want the Suda obviously to be made, but it shouldn't be titled Sudas Chasen, so if Chas V'Shalom somebody wasn't Mesameach the Chasen, he doesn't get punished. So we say, turn it around and let the family of the Kala make it. So yes, it is a Sudas Mitzvah. It is a celebration for the Chasna, but it won't be titled the Sudas Chasen. That is the common answer which is given. In the name of Rabbi Levi Yitzchak Mebeditchev, Bnei Yisachar says another reason. Based on the Zohar. The Zohar in Chela Gimel Vav writes, based on the Pasuk in Amos, that there is a difference between the previous Geulas that Bnei Yisrael experienced and the Geula Shlema, which we're hoping and praying for. The previous Geulas, the previous redemptions that the Yidden were merited to, it says that the Yidden were taken out of exile in that situation, but eventually they were forced back to go to Golus, Rachmana Litzlan. So it's like a married couple that separated, and Nebach, she had to go back. The wife goes back to, at one time there was a merry, fine, happy togetherness, but then with the Golus that continued afterwards, she went back to her old ways. The difference is, in the time Mashiach will come, Emir Tzashem B'Meher V'Yameinu, that will be a final Geula, but not only it's a final Geula, in this case, the Bnei Yisrael waits where they are, and the husband, the Eibishter, this is what the Zohar says, comes to us, comes to Klal Yisrael, comes to Knesset Yisrael. So to symbolize that, the Yidden are considered the Knesset Yisrael as the Kala, the Eibishter is the Chasen, so we make the Kala do the work, and the Chasen comes towards the Kala, symbolic that this is hopefully bringing us closer to the Geula Shlema, where the Eibishter will come to Knesset Yisrael and redeem us from this Golus. So this is a general thing about who's titled on the Suda of the Chasen V'Kala, the Sudas of Nisuin. But then let's talk about some interesting things about the details, some details of perhaps what did Chazal say, what should be served at this wedding. An interesting point I want to mention, that in Bi'er HaLacha, in Mishneh Berurah, in Bi'er HaLacha, in Or HaChaim, Simen Kuf Ayin Se'if Yutes, he suggests, he actually writes, that it's a menschlich thing, that if you're going to somebody else's party, or you're even going to someone else's house, try, and it's a, there is a set time when the party is being served. Try not to come too late to the party. What's the why? Not because you have to be on time, because it could be by the time you show up there won't be enough food left, and the balabas will be upset. He'll feel bad that here a guest shows up and he doesn't have what to serve him. So to avoid this discomfort, please try to come on time and don't come towards the end of the meal. Just a tremendous Musa Haskel. So let me tell you what it says about some of the suggestions what should be served during a chasna meal. It's brought, obviously, a suvas mitzvah you wash, and some actually don't like that people say, moitzi, 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 you know, asking for bread. Some don't like it because there's a famous Gemara. The Gemara says that in Ma'arava, when somebody got married, they would ask the chasen, matzah ay moitzah. Matzah is a pasuk that says, matzah isha matzah toiv. The one who marries a good woman, he found toiv, he found good. And then there's another pasuk that says, moitzah mar mi mavis, moitzah isha mar mi mavis. That Rachman al-Atlan, sometimes a person will be stuck with a wife that's Rachman al-Atlan bitter. A bitter mar mi mavis, Rachman al-Atlan. So they would ask the chasen, oh, you're married. Did you get the matzah, the good one, or God forbid, the moitzah? So some didn't want to mention anything about moitzah in the night, moitzi at night of the chasna, because moitzi is the negative side. However, it's brought in the name of the Rabbi Akiva Eger, it's brought in the Sefer Darkei Chaim, that Rabbi Akiva Eger used to say that actually the night of the chasna, when you come to the meal, people would actually grab from the chasen, the moitzi, and they would ask for moitzi and take it from him. Symbolically, that if God forbid there is some negative, they're taking away the moitzi. They're taking away the negative, and all that the chasen should be left with is matzah isha matzah toiv, only good and only positive. It is interesting to note that when you're dealing with the items that should be served, the menu, so it's brought in Ezer Mikodesh, that based on the Gemara in Brachas, the Gemara in Brachas Daf Mem Dalet writes, Kol suda she'ein basarif ein esuda. Any meal that part of the menu is not sarif, there is no sarif in the menu, that's not considered a chash of a meal. Rashi explains, what is sarif? Sarif, tafshil lach she'yesh by marak. In simple words, a soup. A soup makes it an honorable meal. And therefore we actually find that there were tzaddikim, there were makbid, that whenever, no matter when the chasna took place, winter or summer, there should be soup. Just an interesting point. Now, another point that should be noticed is the meal is being served and it's freilach and people are dancing. There are some people that are makpid that the benching shouldn't be left for after everything. They should somehow, as you danced once or twice, whatever it is, towards the end of, when you finish the main course, you bench then, and then if you want, you could continue dancing, and maybe even serve the dessert afterwards. And in Sfarim it's brought that by doing that, you save yourself at least five benefits by benching right after the main course. Number one, because not everybody stays till the very end, till the light's shut. Now, and if you're going to bench by the end, the people who leave early are not going to hear Sheva Brachas. Why not have them involved in the Sheva Brachas and also be part of the answering the Amen? Another benefit you have, if you're dancing at a chasana and you start and the meal gets spread out over a long period of time, there might be a downtime in between one course and the next course, which becomes a shaila of if you could still bench for the previous course. It all has to be in a proximate period of time. And here, if it gets spread out, it might be a shayla of a hefsik. And then, if you're spreading it out and at the very end you're benching, there's questions whether or not you should make a bracha on the dessert, which comes at the end of the meal. Another thing is a very practical thing, that if you keep on delaying benching to the very end, a lot of people just leave forgetting to bench. They don't even, they just, you know, stretching out, and then I got to go home, and they forget to bench. So, to be sure that all these things are done properly, there are some that are makbid that you actually bench right after the main course and don't wait till the very end.